Hello and welcome everybody to this Extreme RPM broadcast from the second round for NLC Trophy. With me tonight we have a new presenter, and we're gonna go to him in a minute, or well, in a second, basically. But first we have a man which is with me all the time.
Most of the time.
Ben.
Hello everybody, hello.
Ben Willis with me. And we have a new guy. Well, a new chap. He is from Ireland, so if you don't understand a word that he's saying, don't worry.
I'm sure we can translate.
Yeah, we can translate. Possibly. Shane Burke with us.
Hello.
And
so yeah, once we've got quite a packed commentary box for once.
Yeah, we have three guys. We're supposed to have three, but the other one...
You mean four, considering there's three of us, and you just had three again.
No, I said three with plus me.
Oh, I see.
Oh. It's like simple maths gone wrong.
Yeah.
Basically. So yeah, it's the second run from NLC. Today with a kind of a hood system, so you can keep track of the drivers.
Helps out as well.
Yeah. But straight away, how are you guys doing this year in racing?
Terribly.
I asked what. I didn't say.
Oh, oh. What? Oh. Well, I'm doing terribly as well. I haven't done. Most of the seasons haven't started over at different other leagues. Over here, I don't think I've done a race this season anymore. Yet. Yeah. What about you, Shane?
We've been working really hard for the Extreme RPM World Endurance Championship. Kind of trying to figure out what we're racing. We know the Simtech Jota car is doing MP2, but now I think Connor and Carl and Alexander have finally made up their minds to do MP1, so I think after like about three or four switching like classes, but yeah, I don't know if we're going for a championship. Like, we won the MPC championship, but
yeah,
with drivers away for certain weekends, it's gonna be very difficult. But yeah, then other championships, other than that, I don't know, we'll see.
Wicked. Well, today's action is from Brands Hatch, brilliant historical circuit down in Kent in the mighty England.
Yeah. What are you expecting to say?
You meant to be like, oh my god, it's England, it's amazing, it's a great track, you know?
Everyone was expecting you were going to say that.
Good, good.
So they know how Ben works already. It's been like, what, 6 months? Are you commentating?
And you still haven't learned what I do.
Nope. So, brilliant. Yeah, today we have, well, it seems by the times we're watching in practice, a more...
Even?
We're going to say challenge race, but...
Oh yeah, Nuno Pinto's not at the top. What is this?
Yeah, some sort of evils going on. No, I'm kidding. By the times that we're seeing on practice, it's going to be a different kind of race that we saw in Laguna Seca. With this said, we have 25 drivers, which is amazing. Well, if we don't count with one guy called Simrace.TV.
You know what that means, though? There's a higher possibility of crashes.
Yeah.
Just and we all like crashes, so.
Yeah, we have. I was gonna... I was saying before my dad jumped the room and he's still here.
Hey, Dad.
Yeah.
Hey, Enrique's dad.
Yeah. We have more guys, but they are using the same skins as their teammates, so...
That just makes our job even harder.
Yeah, and...
Who do we have who's new? I'm just having a look.
We'll have one Borch 20, Monty.
We have Danny underscore R32.
Yeah.
I think that's everybody. All the new people. Mm. Yeah, so that's everybody there. Oh no. We have Antis here. Anti Heatalan has turned up as well, so that'll be good. 1 minute till qualifying, apparently.
Yeah, and this is the calendar for again. The rest. Yeah. Just a remind. Can you do it?
Oh, you want me to do it? Okay. So, last week we had Laguna Seca. Today we'll have round 3 and 4 from Brands Hatch. And then, is it next week? I don't have the dates here, yep. So next week we're at Nürburgring for rounds 5 and 6. Then after that it's, I think that's Braga for rounds 7 and 8 in Portugal. It's in Portugal, isn't it? It's not on one of the islands, it's good.
No.
And then we have rounds 9 and 10 from Kyalami in South Africa. 11 and 12 come from Helsinki Thunder in the city of Helsinki. That's a street circuit. bit obvious in the name. And finally, our last two rounds will be from Salzburgring in Austria.
Yeah, speedy one. Anyway, qualify should be starting.
It is now. Qualifying has started, and that means 15 minutes for the drivers to post the fastest lap times.
So, if you were to put your bet on someone, who would you bet on pole?
I'm going for Nuno Pinto again, just because he absolutely dominated last week. So, I've got full confidence in him. Enrique?
AJ, just to be different.
To be fair though, he was doing well last week until someone hit him out. Which, coincidentally, there's been no penalty against that so far.
Nope.
So, I know it's, I think it's still in the dispute process, but interesting to see what happens with that. Because it was a very clear cut penalty. Meanwhile, everybody filtering onto track for qualifying.
Some touches here and there, but nothing to worry about.
It's not the race, boys. Slow down.
And overtaking maneuvers in qualify. Whoa, amazing. Anyway, these guys are going for it. Anyway, there's some guys with the Euro Cup car, I think.
Well, they won't get very far with that, as I found out earlier. It's more than like a second off, at least. So
yeah, it's a lot. So you know, some guys were complaining that you don't know who the guy on the image is.
So, do we have a plan for this?
Yeah, this is.
We have a magical plan. Ah, it's an amazing plan.
Ooh.
Monty in the wall already.
Ooh.
And ouch. He took Ian Stewart with him, so yeah.
Fun times.
Victor Souza.
It's on the run down to clearways towards the latter part of the track.
Yeah. Just to say, this clever solution is just for qualifying the race. We don't put that thing in.
Good.
because it's ugly and it doesn't work all the time. Oh, no.
So we're using the GP layout of Brands Hatch for tonight. That means we've got 11 turns, about 2.4 miles of racetrack. This is the layout they used back in the old days for F1, when they used to have it at Brands Hatch, I think, about the 1970s. Meanwhile, Gohan Keeney's already off the track.
Yeah.
Mm. My guy for pole isn't facing the right way, so...
Very hopeful.
Yeah. I think if he finds a gap, gets his head down properly, he should get pole, I hope, from
I think that's
the experience.
The issue with a lot of these cars at the moment, they're stuck behind the people in front. So they'll probably want to get some space.
Yes, but I find people don't like doing that. It's like, it's a simple... off you go, but... it makes qualifying a bit funny.
Certainly does, keeps us interested. 12 minutes to go over on the timer over here. Nobody has actually posted the time yet, which sort of helps.
I actually think this is one of the most difficult tracks on the calendar. It mightn't look it, but to drive is extremely bumpy, especially through the section they're in now.
Yeah.
It is. You don't really appreciate it until you actually do a few laps in these cars. Once you lose downforce in these cars, it just goes and you're really in trouble.
Yeah, there's some crazy elevation changes around here, especially into the first corner into Paddock Hill Bend, where it's pretty much almost blind your exit. So that'll make it interesting for the start of the race.
Yeah, exactly. It's hard to know what rear wing, especially, to run around here. Okay, you can only have 1, 2, or 3 on the rear for downforce, but you want low downforce for the long straights here, but you really need it. Only for the Westfield, you need a lot of downforce for there, so...
Oh yeah, for Hawthorns and Westfield, you need a stupid amount of downforce just to keep it on track, otherwise you're going to end up in a wall.
Yeah, exactly, so I think it'll be interesting to see who picks what, but I don't think it's going to be the quickest person that wins this race. I think it's going to be whoever stays out of trouble.
Yeah. Well, the times at the moment, AJ Yates is leading qualifying with 1:28.86, and then behind him is his teammate Vladimir Morali, 1:29.2, and then third place is with Aldegard for Pro Race Simulation with 1:29.2. But that is only 10 minutes in, so that will probably change.
As always.
Meanwhile, we're on last week's winner of both races, Nuno Pinto. Had an absolute barnstormer last week. Nobody could catch up with him. I wonder if he'll do it again this week, though.
I think Nuno, he's a really big talent in sim racing, so especially, like, he can get into any car and be pretty goddamn quick, so
yeah,
he's one to really watch. You can't count him out.
Well, he's always fast in single-seaters. He's been fast in some of the one endurance cars I've seen him. Got a little vibe there, though, through Westfield. But he's mighty fast in these McGanns as well, so no stopping him.
Oh, no, yep. Even pure control through there, absolutely sideways, and although he had a bit of commentator curse there going wide. yeah,
see, that's the perks of our job. We can just curse everybody and they'll end up in a wall.
Yeah. Well, last week didn't work, so...
Yeah, it didn't work too well, did it?
No.
We'll keep trying.
Yeah. I was talking with... Well, I talked during the week with Nun Gonsalves.
Uh-huh.
Do you remember him?
I do remember.
He went to the pits before he crosses the line. Crossed the line.
So. Oh yeah, that one, yeah. And that he lost a position.
Yeah, he thought that the race had ended by the time he went to the pits, so...
Sort of shot himself in the foot there, didn't he?
Yeah. And, didn't end it. He had to cross the line. Well, anyway.
This section, Nuno Pinto's just coming through now. This has the biggest elevation change on the track, but is also the fastest.
Yeah.
The run up Hawthorns Hill here.
I don't know if you tested this course with these cars.
I know Shane has. I did about one lap and ended up in a wall. So,
yeah. I tested
on top form.
Yeah, I tested last week. Last week. Saturday, basically. Track does is so the car is jumps a lot in there, so if you're thinking on overtaking there, think twice.
Yeah, it's
because you change direction there and it's a wall that you're gonna hit.
I think usually it's such an old circuit and it hasn't been properly resurfaced or changed a good 5 to 10 years now, and considering it's getting a lot of race action. I mean, it's had, like, it's British Touring Cars twice a year. You've got Superbikes, Formula Trucks, Formula Renault, pretty much all the UK club racing. DTM used to go there as well. So it gets a massive amount of use, but it just gets so much use that it's starting to get really old and bumpy. Which doesn't help when you're in cars like these that are quite low to the ground.
They
require a lot of downforce.
Yeah. You can see here, even in the game, and I'm not sure this track is accordingly correct with.
It's close enough.
Yeah, with the reality in terms of surface, but you can see the patches on the tarmac. So.
Yeah, I mean, I went there in October, and we got to stand on the track at the end whilst they were presenting some of the trophies, and it's even on the front straight, it's very bumpy as everybody goes off in the background at 30s.
Yeah, Jair and
Jair went off.
Yeah, and Nuno Pinto too. Even though Nuno Pinto seemed to open up for Michael.
Anyway, we're on Bolshimikov as he comes around the top of the track into Westfield. Now to Bolsha 20 on the front straight as he hits into Paddock Hill Bend. Just look at that. He can't even see the exit. It's blind entry into that.
Continue, go on.
Oh, am I... has this suddenly turned into a me talking about it for a lap kind of thing?
Yeah.
Thanks for the forewarning. Anyway, on down into Graham Hill Bend. Looking good, clips the apex. Out of there onto the keeper straight, which isn't actually a straight. Don't ask me why they named it that. Then into Surtees, uphill left hander, you've got to keep the power through here, otherwise you're gonna go very slow. Now onto the fastest part of the track. As we come down the hill, under the bridge, and then back up the hill, Hawthorns Hill. Turn right through Hawthorns, one of the fastest corners on the track. Looking good through there. Then on the run into Westfield, another one of the high-speed right-handers. Clips the apex again, looking good. Don't want to run too wide, otherwise you can end up in that wall. Now up into Sheen Curve. This used to be a chicane. This was changed a couple of years ago. Still is a chicane on this version, actually. They haven't changed that. Now into Stirling's Bend, looking good through there. Into the second of the long straights. Before we come back into the Indy section of the track. Through clearways. And into the final corner, Clark Curve, before we open back onto a bit straight. And that was a pretty good lap there from Porsche 20.
Yeah, pretty good. Bit messy on the second last corner, but other than that, it's pretty good. And comes out with traffic, and that really upset his first corner.
When I say pretty good, he is 20th overall. So.
Well, that shows you how close and competitive it is here.
Yup. Well, he's 4 seconds off the fastest time, which is Vladimir Morelli. 128.3. But even a good lap round here just isn't fast enough sometimes. Ball with Pedro Gomez now, not one of the AJ Racing cars.
Yeah. And it seems the F1 champion is making something for his name. It's first, right?
Yeah.
So, yeah.
Doing well there.
Yeah. The problem is, if the WEC boys from last year, well, the champions obviously, were here, they would put one hell of a fight too. And when I say this, is Burak Soylu and Marius Nikolaevi, because they are the two.
Well, they're the reigning champions in LMP1, aren't they?
Yeah.
And they are crazy fast. Imagine them in one of these. Remote, if you want to get in touch with us, we have two Facebook pages now. I was looking early. We have the extremerpm.org Facebook page. I believe we also have another one.
Is it the page I run?
Yeah, that one.
Yes,
you have to give the details of that, because I don't know the details.
Yeah, so you can get in touch with us on Facebook, and just type in broadcast team. So you can leave messages and keep up to date what's happening. Through Twitter, of course, you have extremerpm.org.
That's extremerpm sims on Twitter.
That's
alright.
I'm getting new to this.
I'll allow you one mistake.
Thanks. You can find myself, the real SB. You can actually find the live stream pretty easy if you follow europeanmotornews.com, who are actually retweeting this to try to get more viewers, so thank you to them guys.
Yep, everybody wants to get more views. I believe we'll be on Channel 4, Simrace.TV.
Exactly.
So feel free to drop us a message. We'll try and read it out during the evening.
And it's always the same. Warning, make it short, because it's not quick.
we don't have 4 hours to kill.
No, we have 20 minutes or something.
Which is usually full of crashes, so not much of that. Meanwhile, we've actually talked through most of qualifying. We only have 2 minutes left. Morelli's still top, then we have Pinto in second, got himself up to second. We have Hiatalan in third, then Aldegaard fourth. AJ Yates 5th, Given Al 6th, David Rego 7th, Nuno Senna is 8th, the championship creator. Then we have Hugo Silva 9th, and rounding out your top 10 is Machinel. Interestingly, 2 seconds cover that top 10, so it's very close to the top.
Yeah, it's pretty close, I think. It's because it's such a difficult track, people are probably thinking, oh, it's not that close, but really, to be on the limit here, you need to have a lot of skill, so it's quite close, and I find, especially with races here, everyone slows down a good bit, so expecting a close race.
Well, Gerbacchini's just gone top with 127.8. He's just gone 0.4 faster than Morelli. He's really putting down the hammer. And that's good for you, that's your bet. So
yes. Oop.
I wonder if he'll keep it for the race, though.
Yeah, I kind of doubt it. If he goes at speed, which he kind of loves to go at that speed, it won't end well.
He'll be greeted by a wall very quickly.
Yes, very quickly.
That was finished there. It was quickly. Anyway. Yeah, guys, we have, 1 more minute to go?
Less than that, about 37 seconds.
There you go, 37 seconds for the end of the qualifier. If you are a bit bewildered that I'm not talking as much as I normally talk, it's because there's 2 born guys that born with English.
Legwork, because we can speak proper English. Is that exactly right?
Yeah. And I'm having dinner, so...
Ah, lazy. Should have had your dinner before we came on air.
Yeah, but I forgot.
You see, Shane? 100% professionalism. We pride ourselves on being professional. Anyway... on board AJ Yates, he comes through the top of the circuit towards Westfields.
Yeah, 100% professional. And we have been contacted by Radio Le Mans for doing 24-hour.
Oh, yeah, totally. Yeah, I'd love that. Seriously, pay me to go to Le Mans if I want to.
Oop.
Anyway, qualifying is now finished, but everyone in lap can still set their time. Currently, Gerbacchini is still top with 127.8. Mm-hmm. Behind him is Vladimir Morelli for AJ Racing. Nuno Pinto currently third. He's still on a lap though, so is Morelli. Fourth is Hiatalan, he's in the pits, so he can't improve. Adelgooden fifth, he's also in the pits. AJ Yates sixth, he's crossed the line now, so he can't set another time. Given Hour seventh, he's in the pits. Machinel eighth in the pits. David Rego ninth. Nuno Senna tenth. Then we have from 10 downwards, we have Hugo Silva, Pedro Gomez, Juan Boyo, Extraviedo, Jair, just come across the line, he stays 15th. Alvarez Souza now 16th. Then we have Danny underscore R32, please use your real name, really helps, he's 17th. Wes McLaren 18th, Vitor Souza 19th, Ian Stewart 20th. Monty brings up 21st. Enrique's brother Francisco brings up 22nd. Porsche 23rd, and Schumacher 24th. Last but not least is Zazzini in 25th. And that was a very long list. So we've got a 5-minute warm-up session before the race actually kicks off. This is the time where the drivers can practice their starts, get ready, put themselves in the right frame of mind. And also gives us another 5 minutes to talk about random rubbish.
Yeah, which is the best thing we do.
Exactly. As you're talking about, it's not random rubbish, it is racing related though.
Yeah.
Everybody looking forward to the F1 launches? So at the end this week?
Yes and no. I'm not looking forward to the racing, but I'm kind of looking forward to see what they look like. I don't want to listen to them. I'll put my earphones in while they're racing around. But yeah, it'll be interesting. That's all I'll say.
Yeah, because, what was it, back in Sebring we were talking about the front wings and how hideous they're going to look. The whole car's going to look completely different because all the rules have changed. But I believe, is it Ferrari or McLaren are the first to launch theirs? I know someone launches theirs on Friday, and then the rest are just before the first test next week. I have a feeling it's Ferrari.
Yeah, but of course we won't see their actual version. They will give us something similar, because of course if you release your car first, teams will be like, oh god, we went wrong here, we'll copy that design. So
exactly,
we'll see something simple, not the real car.
Expect a lot of ruses to be used, and we won't actually find out what they look like properly until we get to Melbourne, which is not too far away now, actually.
Yeah.
50 odd days.
Ignore that and just wait for March and the first race, and then you're going to see them.
Yes, they're going to mean nothing.
No.
And expect everything to go wrong in Melbourne,
yeah,
because nobody's used these engines before. Everything's probably going to blow up, catch fire, which we all love watching.
Yeah.
It's entertaining. Better than Vettel winning everything, but we shall see.
Yeah, the problem is we won't be there to commentate that.
Unfortunately, we haven't been contracted by the BBC.
No, BBC.
Or Sky.
the BBC didn't reach us yet. Yet. It's March.
Yeah. Who knows? We could see this, and we could suddenly be signed up tomorrow.
Yeah.
Watch this space, everybody. Watch this space.
Yeah. Just a quick reminder to BBC, we are not used to commentate F1.
Yeah, we're used to endurance and a bit of touring cars crashes. So.
Yeah, we're used to endurance, where the cars go round and round for 24 hours, and touring cars, where the cars don't go around at all and crash into each other.
As you can see, our experience is quite limited.
Yeah, and we know a bit of rallying too, thereabouts.
Hey, I actually watched one of the rallies for once. They brought them back onto TV over in the UK. They have them on BT Sport now, which is brilliant. So I got to watch the Monte Carlo rally for once.
And how do you find it?
Amazing. Like, considering I hadn't watched it for like 3 years, because it was on, I think it was on ESPN, which you had to pay for, I think. For once I got to watch it, and it was really good. And I'm looking forward to the next one. So.
Yeah. And do you know what is the next one?
It's Sweden, isn't it?
Yes.
See, I know my rallying.
Yeah, he knows. He doesn't know the brands, but he knows the calendar.
Anyway, we have about a minute and a half left to warm up before we actually get some racing done here. So, another minute to kill.
Well, we can't really talk about the championship since we're only one race in, so can't really say who looks good for a championship yet.
I'm still putting my money on Ino Pinto. I think he's got this in the bag. I really hope he does.
Well, we can talk about the one of the penalties that were applied after the first race.
Which were?
To your friend the X-Men.
Yeah, hold on, I'll go and check the forum. Here we have it, right. Govacchini has a penalty. Oh, that's awful.
Yeah.
It was just added to his total race time from last race.
The X-Man has 15 seconds head to his race total on first race, on second race.
And he will have, he'll be last on the grid today.
Yeah.
So we saw that, he's qualified last.
The 15 seconds head to his total time is not the race from today, it's Logan the second race, and race 2, he also penalised, he's 45 seconds added, and he's last today. Govacchini.
If you want to see this better explained than what we're doing, head over to the forum, extremerpm.org, go and click on the forum, and you can see everything as well as the results. That will have the official classification over there as well. Meanwhile though, we're about to go racing over here. Warm up has finished, so I'd say within a minute we shall be racing. Ooh, and as we talk about moving on to the race, AJ8 spins.
Attention, all non-essential personnel,
here we go, let's get ready for rounds 3 and 4 of the NLC Championship. So everybody's gridding up now on the front straight. I think Enrique's going to change the cameras. That's a hint.
Cough.
I will.
Cough, change camera, cough. You have 10 seconds, apparently. 8, 7, 6.
Oh, the pressure.
Here we go then, watch out for Gavacchini at the front and Vladimir Morelli, but we're ready for round 3 of the 2014 NLC Championship from Brands Hatch and Railway.
Yeah.
Clean start from everybody. Look at Keeney go around the outside of Morelli. Can you make it sticking? Oh, they're touching.
This is going to go badly. And Gavacchini goes wide.
Everybody else, I think, just about making it cleanly through. Now to Drew's head. Oh, Keeney's gone wide. Morelli through. Everybody through, pretty much.
Yeah. And Antti is jumped to third.
Pinto up to second, and GH fourth.
Yeah, he's first.
No other casualties, surprisingly, around the back.
No.
Nobody, no big crashes. Oh, Monty's gone off on the Cooper Strait.
And someone
and we got a spin on there as well. That's Hayer, I think. Just went slightly wrong. Oh, it's Aldegard.
Yeah.
And now apparently on the run through Pilgrim's Drop into Hawthorn's Hill. Fastest part of the track.
Yeah, and apparently my amazing hood doesn't work on the multiplier, which is amazing.
See? Professionalism.
Yeah.
We totally amazing. Tested this thing, the cough.
Yeah, I tested it, and it worked the first time I tested it, and then the broadcast doesn't work, which is amazing.
So imagine, everybody just imagine,
I imagine
there's a hood there.
Yeah, it's a hood, and names are passing by on,
exactly.
over the course. Just imagine.
Which helps us, yeah.
Yeah.
Have we lost a leader, Morelli, who was in first, and I can't see him in sight?
He's down into seventh.
He's obviously made a mistake somewhere.
Probably yep. in the back section. So, look who's in the lead.
No surprise.
No.
My bet is paying off here.
Yeah, and he's being chased down by Antti.
He's staying with it. 0.3 seconds is the gap to come to Druids. Gavacchini's just got himself up to fourth, just past Minas Senna.
I think it's kind of hard to say whose fault it was between Gavacchini and Morelli. It was a closing door, and I think it was a 50-50 accident there, but kind of shaken up the race.
Yeah.
Well, exactly.
The worries now is, has Morelli damaged the suspension on them again?
Yeah, because that would not help, especially on this track, because it has many high-low corners.
Yeah.
I just got a message from Hugo, actually, the guy in charge of the World Endurance. He's put his money on Antti to win.
Obviously, he's an endurance guy.
Cough, no favouritism, cough.
No, we don't do that on XCM.
As we say, 100% professional.
Yeah, 100%. Without a hood, which doesn't work. My dear gear the arm.
Nuno Pinto still has a lead. Anyway. Now up to 0.6 over Hiatalan. Then Adrian Yates in third, Keeney in fourth, and Senna in fifth as they come for laps 3. And we're also 3 minutes into the 25-minute race.
It's quite interesting to watch Pinto.
Sorry, I think he's got problems. I think he's running slower than everybody else. I wonder if he has got suspension.
Yeah. AJ8 with Gavacchini on his trumpet. And Nuno Senna. He's trying to catch up Gavacchini, but he's a bit away.
Hiatton's closed down the gap to Pinto down to 0.5 in the second. And he's keeping up with him down the back straight. Through the fastest part of the track now as they come into Hawthorns.
You could see the cars bumping there.
Absolutely crazy. Both using the maximum amount of kerb as well. Just
yep.
to keep themselves at high speed.
I think Pinto, if he can get one clear lap and pull about half a second more, he will lose the slipstream from behind, so he'll be in a clear air, you could say. But you can see they're both taking quite different lines, and I have a feeling Pinto is running a bit more downforce, possibly, because it seems like he's losing a bit of time in the back section,
especially on straights.
Yeah, and he has to just close up to 5.39 now. So he's getting closer. The question is, he's going to have to get a lot more closer to get past.
Yep. Can't get past my head, the hood quote thing. Bloody hell.
You keep pondering that.
Yeah.
And we'll work on a commentary. We'll do the work. You do the technical fixing stuff.
Oh, there's...
Is it not a config file or something you've got to change?
No, because I changed that and I put all things together and it worked the first time I checked. And now it does. So I have to... Well, next race. I'm gonna...
We promise. Next race. We promise.
Not next race. Next round.
Sorry, it's the next round.
Nürburgring. It's we'll gonna be fixed. Yeah, and we're gonna put something like the WEC thing in.
Oh, the time thing. Yeah, we need that.
Yeah, if possible, we're gonna put that.
Yeah, we'll let someone work on that. Higassin has just taken a tenth of the second out of Pinto in the middle sector. He's definitely got a lot more downforce.
Yep.
Through this middle section, he's just able to keep up with Pinto a lot more, but losing him on the straights.
So, charging a bit up the field, so we have AJ Yates, we have Govankini being pressured by Givernau and Nunserna, two teammates.
That's the battle for fourth there.
Yeah, and has Govankini problems in that right rear suspension?
I don't.
That's
so.
That's where he would have got hit by Morelli. So it's possible.
Yeah, Givernau. Because Givernau is chasing him down quite quickly.
Considering the pace that Keeney had during qualifying.
Yeah.
Interesting.
If I done my math correctly, is fifth, sixth is Nunserna, seventh is. David Rieu. So this is basically the Armada Lusitanium here.
Yep, this is three Lusitaniums together.
Yeah.
Before we get the first of the Canary team.
Yeah. Adal Good with Mirelli and Hugo Silva, all three together. And when I say together, they are pretty
literally
close.
Literally fighting. Oh, you don't want to be fighting there.
No, you don't overtake there. That's a no-no.
Interesting, Morelli's had an absolutely shocking start to this race after getting squeezed out.
Yeah.
Oh, we've had a retirement. Danny R32 has retired. So has Borja 20. Borja 20 retiring with suspension damage. Danny R32 retiring as well, so that's two Pro-Race simulation cars out.
Yeah, that's not good.
As I say that, a third one goes out. Payet has just retired, Pro-Race Sim again.
And Mirelli is trying to overtake Adalgood.
Can he do it into paddock?
Yeah.
Oh, he's getting squeezed out wide. That's some brave defending there by Adalgood.
Yeah.
He's going to try into Juris again. Yeah. They're weaving all over the place.
Yeah. F1 tactics there.
Exactly.
You can see that he's F1 because you think he's going one way and he changes the direction of the car so quickly that you know it's F1 tactics being applied.
Surely it's only a matter of time till Morelli gets past though because he's all over him.
Yeah.
Is he going to try up into Hawthorns again? That'd be very brave.
He got a very good drive out of the corner.
Yeah, he's got the slipstream. He's going to go left.
Oh, he's going around the outside.
Aldega's squeezing him. Oh, giving him little room.
Oh.
Be careful, boys, you're going to take yourselves out.
Yeah.
He actually got so close there, he could not see where the corner was, so it'll take another lap or two to gain all that time back.
Like coming through these blind chicanes with Bingo Dale.
Or just one corner, well done.
Exactly. All it takes is one corner and you've got the line of him. Meanwhile, Pinto extending his gap over Hiatton to a second now. Starting to pull away. And then Morelli's dropped back a bit.
Yeah, Pedro Gomes is in the pits. I don't know why.
I'll keep an eye on that one.
Oh, going very wide nearly in the first one.
He's really pushing, isn't he?
Yeah.
Aldegaard locked up then.
Yeah.
But kept it online.
Yeah. Quite a strange line from Aldegaard. Very tight on the inside.
That's going to cost him time, though. He needs to watch out. The gap now is just over a second between Aldegaard and Morelli. So you're not going to get the slipstream anymore. It's all about raw drive from the corner. Keep an eye on Hugo Silva in the background. He'll be trying to spoil any mistakes.
He's too far away a bit.
If they take each other out, though.
Yeah.
He's in ample position to a capital. Oh, Morelli goes wide. Can you save it?
Will he collect Silva, though?
Silva's gone wide.
He's not going to keep
He's lost it at Westfield. Is that now classed as a dangerous re-entry to the track?
No.
It's your left in no situation to only go on that speed. And Silva, I think he should have slowed down just to be safe. Yeah. But
yeah.
Well, there's the first part of drama.
Yeah.
Weird.
And AJ being pressured by Giovanchini that
didn't work first time. Keeney.
Keeney's trying to go past Yates.
Yeah.
He has to have him now. Doesn't see him.
And Keeney just gets out of shape there into Graham Hill.
Yeah.
There's the frustrating. He's flashing his lights.
Yeah.
3:30 is now on the run. He's a bit too far back though to make a move into Hawthorns.
I think Keeney, I think he's feeling the pressure from Genpole and dropping back straight away at the start. I think he just needs to have patience as he gets a really good run on AJ Yates.
Yeah.
He's really dropping behind the front two, so I think we're just waiting now for Keeney to get past, but Keeney, he won't catch the front two. They're way ahead.
He's got 14 minutes to catch up. I think he just needs to calm down a bit and keep it on the track.
Yeah, especially since Keeney had at least a 5 second gap to catch AJ Yates there, and he's only after doing it in about 2 or 3 minutes, so he's much bit quicker when he's more calm. But
exactly. Well, they're going over to start at 8th lap. We've had 12 minutes of the race so far. Pinto Studio lead, he's got 1.3 second gap over Hiatalan. Then it's AJ Yates, go back Keeney, Givenall, Nuno Senna in 6th, David Rago 7th. Then it's Aldegaard, Morelli and Souza rounds out your top 10.
AJ Yates gets a bit wide but gets a really good exit this time compared to last time.
Yeah.
And Joe Van can't get near him again.
It's interesting, it's in every corner, it's just the balance is just swinging slightly. Sometimes Keeney's closing and then
he's really close now. I think Keeney's taking more risks. He's going really to the far edge of the track where AJ Yates is playing it a little bit safe, but that's left himself wide open for this corner here.
Now, will Keeney he's very close. Will he make a move into Westfields possibly? Can't do it through Hawthorns.
Oh, but AJ Yates runs wide a little bit.
He thought, but does he has the tyres to do it?
Zazzini went wide there.
Yep. Does he has the tyres? Because we have 12 laps in, and we know these tyres don't last long, so...
And Keeney's been pushing a lot, so
yeah.
His tyres going to be more worn than Yates, who's trying a bit more conservatively. Look at him try and go for a dive just before clearways.
So, who chose Giovanchini?
Me.
And I chose Yates, so yeah, it's between
I'm winning again.
It's between me and you.
Nuno Pinto winning again.
Yeah.
Jovan has to have
AJ
Yates
gets really good. He's going to go around the outside.
Maybe.
Oh, he's got a perfect run
inside.
Into Druids now.
Yeah.
Sure, this is surely a move.
Yeah, that was a smart move by AJ. Just to let him through and maybe follow him and try catch up to the first two.
Can he get the drive for Graham Hill? He's too far back to... He's dropping back quite a lot.
Yeah. Hey, Giovanchini is going because AJ...
It's a wise thing to do. Keeney was all over him. You don't want to risk taking each other out.
Oh, but Jovan's way off in the grass and just keeps out of the wall, but he's still messed up.
Yates
and
is gonna
AJ
have to run down into Pilgrims.
Yeah, and that was the curb.
That is the curb. Now here they go, side by side into Hawthorns. Who's going to make it stick? Yates have got it.
Yeah. This is a massive fight for...
this is for fourth. Third.
Third?
Yes, it's for the last podium spot. Keeney is all over Yates.
And one of the back markers.
No one on the back markers. This could cause some issues.
And back marker goes off under the pressure.
Yeah, under pressure and he goes wide.
It leaves, like, AJ Yates, you feel bad for him now. He made the move easy for Jovan just to go and for Jovan to mess up, and now it's the same situation as the last lap.
Here
they go into Paddock Hill.
Jovan scrubs off speed on the exit, but he's still going up the inside.
Straight down the inside for Druids.
There's contact. Yeah, contact.
And rightfully gives the place back.
Yeah, you couldn't see because of the elevation change there, but...
And every lap it's just swinging back and forth, and these tyres now are just going to be absolutely destroyed the amount they're having to push to stay in front.
But one thing we haven't noticed is Givernow, who is really kind of sneaking up. He's gaining about a tenth or two each lap, but he could catch them.
He's only 3 seconds behind now, and with every... fracas that the two at the front are having, he's closing in as Keeney tried to go around the outside. He can't surely do this into Wakefield's, can he?
This is as close as you want it to here. You don't want it any closer.
Especially after the chicane here into Dingle Dell. He's got it wrong.
Sideways,
he just took too much of the first exit, but now Yates is locked up into Sterling.
Jovan won't really get up the inside here. It's too far of a gap, but he's just setting himself up.
He will set himself up for Paddock Hill, possibly, or Druids.
Jovan Keeney has a lot more straight line speed, as you can see here.
Here we go. He's going to go into Paddock, isn't he?
Yeah.
Straight down the inside. But there's contact.
Almost. Jovan Keeney going wide.
Yates goes to the undercut, down the inside again.
Easy.
Brilliant manoeuvres here.
That's
a big contact.
Yeah, and possibly damage on the front left suspension for Jovan Keeney.
Yates is really getting battered about again like he did last race. Seems to be a recurring theme. Is he going to make a dive into Surtees? He does. Can he make it stick? He's got the inside, but he cuts it across Yates.
Too much speed after. Yeah. They will get caught at this race.
Yeah. Yates is getting the undercut. And
Givernow is coming.
He's closed it down to 2 seconds to get out now.
He's taking 1 second out in one lap, so just give them... He really wants these two to keep battling the way they are.
Yeah, it's sitting perfectly for him. Meanwhile, Pinto still has a 1.3 second gap at the front over Hiatal. Meanwhile, we're staying on this battle because this is absolutely amazing driving here.
Yeah. The bell...
Look at the sliding!
Yeah, and he's lost ground for AJ.
Yates is just catching up through Sterling there, under the Foster's Bridge.
So we have...
Yeah, given out on the background, so they come through clear ways.
Yeah, so we have a Dutch, a guy from the mighty England... And
the mighty UK?
Yeah, and then a Portuguese guy coming on the background. Who's going to win? The Dutch is...
I don't know, Keeney's starting to pull away from Yates now.
Yeah. If he makes a mistake, then Yates can...
This is possible, the amount he's pushing just to stay in front.
They're not that far away, but if he makes a mistake, and you saw the mistakes that you can make on this track, especially on this corner, because of the exit curb.
Yeah. Interestingly, Hiatalan's just taken about 3 tenths of a second out of Pinto.
Yeah. And you could see Govan pushing hard because he got oversteered quite a lot on that corner.
Now into Hawthorns. Yates is too far back to make any real move.
Yeah, but he's just on the slipstream.
All he needs. All he needs is the slipstream. That's where he's lacking his speed, so if he has more downforce through corners and the slipstream, he will really benefit for this.
And look, he's...
Without going sideways.
Yep.
Wow, what is this? We've got a back marker in front, Juan Poyo. That's going to cause some issues. He pulls out the way.
Yep. Blue flag.
They've dropped Jivr now by a good bit now. He's really kind of lost any hope of getting that third place.
Yeah. Oh, Henrique, your brother's retired.
Yeah.
Francisco is out for Star Alliance Motorsport.
Apparently. Trying to know.
Pinto's gap down to Pinto's gap down to 1.2 seconds, and Keeney's gone very well. He's spun on the entrance to.
Will he collect Jivr now, though? Yes.
That's some dodgy driving there. To be fair, though, he couldn't do much because he was spinning away. Now, can Nuno Senna capitalise on this?
Senna, I think he'll go for a move.
Yep. Straight into Surtees, and Aldega's going to think about it as well.
Oh,
you don't go three wide into Surtees.
Well, you can try, and he tried.
Oh, Jesus Christ, look at Aldega trying to get past.
Aldega did give a flash to warn he was going to go the inside, but
they're going to battle into Hawthorns.
Yeah.
Keeney straight past, good move.
Yeah. Senna is coming back.
Into Westfield, can he make it stick now? No. Keeney's just got in front, but look at them scrapping all over fifth place.
And a good passing by.
Oh, a bit of rubbing.
It's a bit, they're all squabbling here. Meanwhile, 88's has been given some clear air now. You can bridge the gap over given out in third.
Yep.
Here they come on the run down to Clearways. Keeney leading the train of cars.
Yep. AJ8's Andy and Nuno Pinto. Nuno Pinto's had, well, it controlled the race basically.
Yeah, we've got 4 minutes to go and he's still controlling the race, but he has a 1.3 second gap. He's kept that relatively stable over here to him. He seems to lose a lot of time through this midsection of the track, where he's running, must be running a lower downforce.
Yep. And he just gets closer.
Certainly does.
How much time left?
We have just about 3 minutes. Just over up.
3 minutes to go on the first race of the second round of the NLC Trophy. Presented by you by XMRBM.
Yep, just under 3 minutes now. So they've got enough time for about. They could possibly just squeeze two laps in.
Yep.
I think if they go fast enough.
Back markers, always a difficult thing to overtake.
Yeah, we've got Ian Stewart and Victor Souza up ahead. We've got a negotiate pass for them. But once again, Pinto's control at the lights to flag.
Yeah.
And he wasn't starting from pole this time, so. That's a surprise. But remember, with the reverse grid, he's going to start all the way down 15th next round.
Well, if he does like last race, when you say last race, is the second race from the first round.
So from Laguna, yeah.
He comes from 5th to 1st in 2 laps.
Which
is not good for fighting, is it? You know, one guy is coming. If you know that one guy is coming from 5th to 1st and 2 laps, just give up.
Where you can make up, go from 10th to 1st in one corner.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Well, you just need a good start, don't you, and hope everybody else on next and be fine.
Yeah, oh. Especially a Mondello.
Why is Pinto still pushing? He's like. Oh, that'll be why. The Atalan is now 7/10 behind.
Ooh.
This may not be over. We've got less than 2 minutes to run.
Yeah, the tyres.
I think Pinto's tyres are starting to go, and now the Atalan can capitalise. He's sat back for most of the race. And now we've got traffic up ahead. Victor Souza. Will he get out of the way? He should.
Yeah, it will.
He does take the inside line, though, which is not good. Well, that's causing Pinto some headaches. Jeez, that's close. Gap down to 4/10 in a second. In that last sector alone, he has them to 3/10 out of Pinto.
So, yeah. The tyres.
This is going to be the last lap, though. We have less than a minute to run. So, Hiaslan has one lap to change it.
Yeah. And you could see here the strategy from a GT driver against an F1.
sit back, save your tyres, and then go for him at the end. Let's watch on board from the Athlon for the end of the race, see if he can make it past. He's just about closing down the straight into Hawthorns.
Yep. Oh,
he's been stuck. That could cost him.
Oh, he keeps out of Waldo.
But now we've got to see, where is AJ Yates?
It's not a safe place to rejoin.
AJ Yates is just coming through Hawthorns now. Yep.
And he managed to secure the second place, but this man is going to win again.
And that's pretty much sealed it for Pintar, unless he makes a mistake. He's only got two corners to go now. And as we said, another lights to flag victory, pretty much. Absolutely cracking drive from the man. And that just cements himself at the top of the leaderboards. Your winner of round 3 of the 2014 NLC Championship, Mr. Nuno Pinto again.
Nuno Pinto first, and he's second. Ooh. With that mistake.
Still driving on the ragged edge.
Yep.
Second. Past the traffic on the front straight. AJ Yates third for AJ Racing.
Fourth is Givernau.
Good drive from him. Was able to capitalise on Keeney's mistake, who brings up fifth.
Sixth is Adal Good. Seventh is Nonsena. Eighth is David Regu.
Vlado Morelli for AJ Racing brings up ninth.
Yeah.
Shame about him. He started up in second. Yeah. Made a mistake on that first lap and it cost him. Hilario Souza now just coming down the back straight, and he's your 10th finisher, unless Machinel can get past.
Machinel
has. He's some way behind.
Yeah, and he has the X-Men between him and Hilario Souza, so. That's not gonna happen.
So, Hilario Souza comes across in 10th, Machinel will finish 11th.
Yeah.
Behind him, it's Extra Viedo for Pro Race, he'll bring up 12th. Hugo Silva for Lusitanium, another one of their drivers. He brings up 13th.
Yeah, Hugo Silva, after that mistake on one of the right-hand corners. Shumikov?
Yep, he brings up 14th. Wes McLaren, another one of the AJ Racers, for 15th. Followed by yet another AJ Racer, Ian Stewart in 16th.
Yep. And that's it. We still have
a couple of people running, I think. We've got Victor Souza is running. Behind him, Pedro Gomez will finish 18th. Zazzini 19th. Monty 20th. And our last finisher is Juan Poyo, who's 5 laps down in 21st.
Just received a message from. He says that he has problems on his computer and the game freezes 2 seconds. Every 2 seconds the game freezes. So
who was
that's
that?
Good.
Juan Poyo.
No, Nuno Pinto.
Oh, that's not good.
Nope. And he says that he's playing, he's driving just to keep the car on the track.
Well, he's done a bloody good job considering he won it.
Yeah.
So, I think that was a pretty good race one. We've got another 5-minute warning. Warm-up even, not warning. And then we'll have race two.
So, your thoughts on the race. Who would you put your bet on, actually, for race two?
I think Nuno Pinto. Again, I think he can come through the field and do another Laguna Seca-style race. I think he's got it, unless Govacchini can pull something out of the bag.
If he can keep a clean nose, he could easily win it, but I think that nose will be going into a bin.
Yeah. Yep. I'm just reading the driver chat at the moment. AJ Yates and Govacchini having a good little bit of banter. Obviously, they had that massive battle for about 5 laps.
Yeah. Shane, since this is your first, first race commentating with us, basically. How was it?
Yeah, it was pretty good. I'm kind of used to commentating on 24-hour races where I have to stay up for 24 hours straight, but it was really good action.
Yeah.
Good.
Well, good, and 17 laps, by the way. 17 laps they managed to do. And now there is...
So now your HUD pops up.
Yeah.
And then hides again.
No, because it's just for the race, the thing.
Ah, I see.
See?
Well, as the server loads up for another 5-minute warm-up, it's that time where I go and grab my cup of tea.
Yeah.
As a true Britishman.
Yeah.
I'll be back in 2 minutes.
So, keeping with traditions, Shane, you going to lager or something? A beer?
No, I'm still in school, so I don't think drinking on a school night will be a good idea.
How old are you?
I'm 18.
Bloody hell, these guys are all young. I'm old already.
I can't kill all my brain cells with drink yet. I'll wait until I'm done school, which is in 4 months, then I'll throw them down the drain.
Be careful with that. You know what happens.
Will do.
We know what happens when you drink too much.
Being Irish, I really do know what happens.
Oh, I see.
Yeah, typical Irish.
Well, yeah, basically. I didn't want to say that, but since you were saying...
We all know what people think of Irish people, and yeah, it kind of is true.
Did this conversation just get awkward?
No.
Not at all.
I just jumped in and you started talking about Irish people.
Yeah. Well, you know the kind of things people think about Irish.
Well, we're all friends here.
Yeah, we are. Nobody said the contrary, I think.
Actually, Mr. Joe Vanchini just messaged me on TeamSpeak. It reminded me, I predicted it right, that the quickest person won't win the race. Like, oh yay, at least I was right with something.
So you sort of won a bet there.
Yeah, so
you all owe me now. Now I won that first race bet, you all owe me. I don't know what you owe me, but you owe me something.
Beer.
I'll take it. Gotta get a ship from Ireland though.
Damn it.
Yeah, would be worse if you'd come from here, but...
Oh yeah, you can send one from Madeira as well.
Yeah, I'm gonna send you that yellow drink.
That weird drink you linked last week.
Yeah.
And I'll take a pass on it.
Why?
It looked a bit weird, to say the least.
It isn't! It has alcohol. Since alcohol, everyone likes alcohol, apparently.
Exactly.
Well, but instead of having 10 or 12% of alcohol, it has 50 or 60 or something like that.
Enough to knock you out.
I don't know. I think it's less than that, but just to dramatize things.
Ah, we love drama.
Yeah, we do.
Well, on that basis then, I'm putting another bet on Nuno Pinto for next race.
So Jovant?
Yeah. I just received a message from Ugu.
Uh-huh.
This is for Shane.
Dun dun dun.
Oh god.
Yeah.
What have you done wrong now?
I don't know.
I cannot put that on...
Uh-oh.
On...
Is it unbroadcastable?
No. I cannot put it. Unfortunately. Or I can. I don't know. Wait. Let's see. Let's see what's what.
That's quite random to show broadcasters or people that are watching.
Yeah. Told you, we're not professional.
No.
There you go.
That's funny.
That's from Ugu, the WEC director for Shane Burke. A driver.
Exactly. Well, we've only got 2 minutes, 2.5 minutes of the warm-up to go before we get going again.
And now I'm going to test if this thing of the hood works.
Go on then. Let's hope and pray, everybody. Hope and pray.
Yeah, 2 minutes. In 2 minutes, I'm going to find out.
And then we find out it breaks.
No. Well, at the moment, you're looking at...
lovely beautiful picture.
Yeah, about NLC Trophy 2nd Edition, Megan Trophy, Burns Hat. There you go.
The rolling hillsides of Kent with a big racetrack on it.
Yeah, well, when you say it's big, it's, 2 miles?
2.4 miles.
Whoa,
11 corners apparently, so absolutely massive.
At least it's bigger than Ireland's biggest circuit, which is Mundello. I don't know how big Mundello is, but it's not that big.
It's not
big.
That big, is it?
No. It's all cramped into a big squiggly...
squiggly
field.
Mess of tarmac.
If that's all it is.
Exactly.
But I have to like it, I guess.
Well,
or you just become a convert, just come over to Britain and...
Talking about that, I have a karting racetrack, and that's it.
Oh, that's pretty bad.
Well, it is an island with...
yeah, but you can still have a racetrack. You can make it around the airport or something.
30 miles from one end to the other. It's not big.
You should make it around the airport. Just have it go brilliant racetrack.
Yeah, it's got a big straight, and then if you don't brake on the end, before the end, you will learn what it is to dive into the sea with a car.
Exactly. It's about 30 seconds of warm-up left over here.
Yeah.
And look who set the fastest time. Just saying.
My guy has been only talking away to me, so that's my excuse. He hasn't driven a lap.
Lazy. Slacking.
That's the way to do it.
Yeah. I just been monitoring the stream, and we have 18 spectators at the moment.
What?
That's amazing.
All new record.
We never had that amount.
for a sprint race, we never had. Obviously for the endurance, we had 50 or something like that in one race. So.
Well, hello to all of you 18 people. Did I just say 80? I think I'm being a bit optimistic.
Keep dreaming.
And one of them just ran away.
Okay, hello to all 17 of you. We're not scary. We don't bite.
Yeah, and the warm-up just finished.
So yeah, it's what, 25 minute race again?
Yep. Reverse course. So 15 minutes. Yeah, McLaren on pole, then Schumacher, then Hugo Silva, Extra Viedo, Machinal, Hilario Souza, Vladimir Morelli, David Rego, Nuno Senna 9th, Aldegood 10th, Gavacchini 11th, Givenchy 12th, AJ Yates 13th, 14th for Hiatalan, and 15th for Pinto.
There you go! Professionalism from Ben Wills.
So, let's get ready then for the round 4 of the 2014 Extreme RPM NLC Championship.
And the freaking boot doesn't work again.
Oh well, we'll roll with it. And the red lights are on as we cut live. And
a slow start from people in the mid pack, and McLaren gets really bad start.
Look at Machinal dive down the inside as well.
Yeah, and Shumikov is already in first.
They stream through Paddock Hill. Oh, there's contact in the background. Someone spinning.
More spinning.
More spinning.
Three guys.
Three rest into Druids.
In the middle. Oh, Jovan gets a really big hit from behind. Don't know who that is. Looks like Pinto possibly.
AJ Yates down to 13th. He's got squeezed out by Pinto and Givenchy as they come down the copper straight.
And Mirelli here fighting with Makiel. Oof.
Ooh, Jovan takes a big chunk up the inside and follow Morelli through. Look, hopefully they won't hit each other like last time.
No, I wouldn't put it past him. Ian Stewart's crashed off just before Surtees. I'm just seeing that on my screen.
Yeah.
We had a new guy who just joined. Hector Rivero for Pro Racing Sim, up to 20th.
West McLaren and Govanchini touching each other, and he managed to pass on that corner, which...
Well done.
It's a no-no.
It is.
And Morelli is coming.
Oh, this is some brave stuff.
Yeah.
Oh, someone going very wide in the background.
Yeah.
I think that was Seattle.
Oof.
Ooh, Jovan gets held up on the exit, but he has power down, and he might make two or three places up.
Look at Morelli just go around the outside.
He's second already. Oh,
and that's big crash. Big crash. That's Keeney. And Extra Viedo. Both in the wall. Keeney's going to keep going, but he's got. Is he missing a wheel?
Yeah.
And he goes past the
wheel,
pits.
Yeah, he is.
Is he?
He's like leading on one side, I don't know.
Yeah, he's missing the left back wheel. Or back left wheel.
Something's wrong. Because, oh, he's... Oh, dear.
Ah, he's gone.
Oh, and he's gonna...
That was uncalled for.
That wasn't clever to carry on. And he retires subsequently. Yeah, Porsche 20 is out as well. No, he's gonna keep going. Watch where you're rejoining, mate. Jeez.
And he's lost the wheel too. And he's up on a fence.
He's up on a fence at Druids and he's retired.
Yep.
That's two races, Porsche 20 is retired.
Yeah, AJ Yates and Nunsen are fairly back on the back, and I think Nunsen has damage 4 on his Renault, I think, on the front.
Yeah, Porsche 20's got some serious damage, he's just spinning about over at Druids. Meanwhile, Senna's going to try and get past Yates. Zazzini, X-Man, has spun off there on the exit of Hawthorns.
Yep.
And Mr. Giovanchini sent me a message simply saying that was it. As simple as.
Well, that didn't go too well.
No.
The big winner out of all this, though, Nuno Pinto from 15th to 6th in one lap. Told you I'd put my money on. And he's only 4 seconds off the leader of Vladimir Moretti.
And he's trying to get to the 5th.
Can he get past Machinel into Paddock Hill?
Oof, McLaren going very sideways.
Well, he's going to stick with him. Can he do it into Druids?
Maybe. And Hugo Silva!
Down the inside, we've got Silva running wide, and Pinto's going to take both of them.
Yeah.
Surely, this is Lusitanium on Lusitanium there.
Yeah. Team Orders?
Exactly, now West McLaren really needs to get out of the way. Pinto's a lot faster.
Yeah. And Pinto is going, and he's trying to make it stick, and it is.
So that's 6th to 3rd in half a lap.
Yeah.
Is there no stopping this guy?
Well, he's got to catch Mirelli and Shumikov, which...
Mirelli's given himself a 3-second gap over Shumikov, who in turn has a second gap over Pinto.
But it's not that big, the gap from Shumikov to Pinto, but... I've seen smaller things. And Pinto is already on top of him, so yeah. From 15 to 2nd into 3 laps.
3rd.
Well, he's 2nd now.
Looking at the list of retirements, we only have Keeney's out. Next to
what did
out.
I say to you?
Pinto run outside.
Yeah, outside, 2nd.
Porsche 20 is just pitting, so we actually only have one retirement at the moment, that's Keeney.
Yeah, and Porsche 20 didn't?
No, he's still going, he's just pulled into the pits.
Bloody hell, that guy is amazing.
Damage limitation, though.
Yeah. He should work for NAS or something.
Nino Pinto is 2nd. He's got a 5-second gap to overturn though to Morelli. Which is really only this straight run at the moment.
I think Morelli, the only reason why he was starting so high up for this race was because of the contact with Giovanchini. But he has the speed, the same speed as Pinto, so I think it'll be a very hard job for Pinto to catch up.
My bet could be in threat here.
Yeah. And you go on board as you listen to my brother complaining about something. and you go on board with the Pinto. Which third on that corner, let's see how which gear he does this one.
Through Dinglish. How is he taking that in 4th?
Well,
that is crazy commitment.
Yeah.
I think the faster you go into these cars, the more force it produces, so it's much easier than going slower through there.
Yep.
Yeah.
And since they don't have that much horsepower, then you don't go that fast, so you have to push.
Yeah, exactly. Into Paddock Hill Bend now, look, blind entry. And hits the apex, very nice.
For those who don't know, these cars have 335 horsepower.
There was a rear-wheel drive, which makes them an absolute devil to drive.
Yeah, so if you want to compare it with the LMP1 car, don't. Because an LMP1 car has more... well, on the paper it says 600 horsepower or something. But on reality, they don't have 600, they have more, a lot more.
Crazy, and also gambling. hence why we can't compare. We've still got a 5.7 second gap between Noreen and Pinto, so not much change there.
Well, I was talking about Olympia 1s, but the expert here on Olympia 1s is Shane.
You just got yourself talked into that one.
Yeah.
Yeah, Olympia 1s, they're... I wouldn't say they're easy, but... It depends what car, like our car, the Creation, which we won the NPC Championship here last time. It was quite easy to drive, but for example, Sebring, it was really hard. So I think they're a nice stable car, but these Meganes, they're so on the wired edge. It's like a Formula 3 car on drugs. It's crazy.
Or a Formula 1 car with no downforce.
Yeah, they're just so twitchy.
Yeah. I don't think that rear wing at the back does much, to be fair.
No, not enough.
Indeed. We are flicking through the drivers now. And on board Pedro Gomez there, who is down in 12th for AJ Racing. Oh look, it's Enrique's brother, Francisco.
Well, I listened to him saying something, and that I guess he was on the medal.
And then he got overtaken.
Yeah, and he was on the medal for a position, and he got overtaken. So
by Nunu Senna, the championship creator.
I think it's kind of surprising to see Senna all the way down here, because last season he raced a Volvo in a league like this, and he's way up front. So it's getting close, though.
Oh, your brother's off in the wall. And subsequently spins across the track. Oh, Ian Stewart's gone off right next to him as well. And then wants the slipstream.
Bum draft.
Brilliant, yeah. Proper NASCAR there. X-Men there, not doing too well, down in 20th. Over a minute and a quarter off the leader.
Oh,
Hayes got it seriously wrong in Westfields. That's gonna do some damage.
Yeah, and he's not on the place.
Is that some kind of oil on the track over there?
I think that's suspension damage. It's not.
Zazzini's gone off there as well. Zazzini, yeah. No, he's spun a difficult lot of the track, but he's still spun. They're all spinning now.
Yeah, and AJ pressuring Ugo.
And he's got Pedro Gomez right behind him, one of his teammates. One of his many teammates.
Well, if you want to consider Lusitanium SR Pro and Junior teammates.
Exactly.
Oh,
he couldn't make it stick.
Nope.
But now look at this, we've got a train of about 6 cars going up into Hawthorns. This can't go well.
But... it will, as always.
Hopefully. Well, Gaslin looks down the inside. Yates is going to try and get passed into Westfield, can he? No. Yates will lay the back of Silver.
I think McLaren is really holding up this group now. Really holding them up.
It's a proper
bat
market.
Oh,
it's
all
gone wrong
in
Sterling.
Yeah.
It was gonna happen. Yates, Silva, Gomez involved there as well. And let's watch that again.
It was all caused by McLaren going wide, and then everyone kind of following him where he's breaking in.
Well, Silva had
to
back
problem.
Off, didn't he? And then Yates just clips Silva. That causes the spin, and then Gomez has nowhere to go. Indeed, there we go. Campoyo just escaping around the side of all that. Meanwhile, back with Gomez now.
Yates is off in the background.
He's gone off again. What happened there? He goes and tries to pass Hugo Silva into paddock.
He does, but doesn't
he
manage.
He does. What happens then?
Stick. No.
Did he go off at Drew's? Did he get?
He
got hit.
Oh.
That's twice now Yates has been hit over 2 races. And he's retired again. Oh, it's such a shame. That's 2 race 2s that he's got taken out of. Deary me, not going too well then for him. Meanwhile, Pinto's closed the gap to 4.5 seconds, taking a second out of Morelli. And we're about halfway into this race now, about 12 and a half minutes. Meanwhile, another train of cars just forming there, behind David Rego.
It's kind of interesting to see some of the top 3, 4, 5 people from last race kind of struggling to make their way through to the top of the grid this time around, but Brands Hatch is a very, very difficult place to overtake, so making the racing quite interesting.
It's one of those circuits where you've got to be brave to pass. And you can see it now, because some of the top drivers just struggling there. Kiatlin down in 8th. We've got Senna down in 14th, that's not good.
That's big news to me.
Yeah, given how I'm struggling down in 6th. Only Pinto and Morelli have really managed to break away now. And they're forming, I guess you could call it a leading group, there's 4 seconds between them. And then Machinelli is 16 seconds off the leader in 3rd. Meanwhile, on board with David Rego, currently in 5th with Lestonia Messar. He's got his teammate Givenaud behind him, who's catching up very rapidly as they come through Stirling.
Yeah. Quite big difference in speed.
Exactly. And Givenaud's going to try and pass into clearways, is he? He's a bit too far back. But with the straight line speed he's got, surely he can take him into paddock.
And you can see here.
Okay, he's going to think about it. He's going to think about it, but no. Just wait for the next corner.
Oh. Couple of corners because he's quite far away. Oh.
It depends, though. Joyce is one of those corners where you can just slam it under brakes. Is that Aldergood off?
Yeah.
Aldergood went off the exit of Druids.
He'll get caught now, easily. Enough, not
and
here.
He is in 4th, but he's going to get caught by Rego. This is going to be interesting as they come into the Surtees.
And someone off up ahead.
Oh, extra Viedo is off as well. He's one of the back markers. Rego and Aldergood, look at them battling. On the run up to Hawthorns now. Aldergood, will he slip
through?
Oh, look at this. Can he take him into Hawthorns? Surely.
Aldergood, no, he's there though. I don't think he knows.
Oh. That is tight. Givenaud just can't get past. And he's the one losing out here. He's losing the most time just getting involved in the scrap. We've got traffic up ahead in the form of Victor Souza, all the way down on 18th. Oh, Aldergood's going wide! He saved it.
Oh, no!
That's a crash. And Heslin got clipped as well.
Yeah.
That was through Dingledale, wasn't it? It's one of those corners you get one of the apexes wrong and goodbye, you're off. Let's watch that again then, on board with gear now. Watch first, Aldergood just loses it under braking, slides a bit. Goes across one of the kerbs and then just it snaps on him. And look at the closing speed. Givenaud, maybe he should have gone slightly further to the left, but when you're at that high speed, quite difficult.
No, he had no choice. Believe me, you go through there so quick, it's just like one corner. Although there's like 3 little kinks, it's just one corner and you have no time to react.
Exactly. I mean, they're in 4. And then there's Seattle. Who had to take some a high amount of emergency action. There's Aldergood just falls off into the wall.
And that's a suspension problem there.
Yeah, he's definitely got some damage now. Givenaud going wide as well, using as much of the course as he can.
Yeah, and he's got damage on that right suspension. And woof, and they're steering a bit.
Morelli's holding the gap well at the front. Just under 5 seconds still.
Yeah. Pinto with that problem in the computer, I don't think he's gonna catch Morelli.
On board with the leader then, Vladimir Morelli. He's got traffic ahead in front of Borgia 20.
And these guys don't like distance plates because they tear them down.
Exactly.
They crash into them.
Yeah, they don't need it, don't like it.
No. Well, you can see this. 200 meters is okay, but from 100 to 50, they just crash into them.
And they're just trying to use as much of the track as possible, aren't they? Rarely easily pass the traffic.
It's one track, actually, you don't really want to come up to traffic, especially in this section. It's
so many blind corners, isn't there? Yeah. You're going so far, so many blind apexes, you don't want to go around the corner and find out there's three cars you got a lap.
Yeah, so I have to say, well done to backmarkers, they haven't caused any trouble today.
Exactly. Pinto's taken a tenth out of Morelli's lead, down 4.6, but he's got 7 minutes to make up the difference.
Mission impossible, unless Morelli makes a big mistake.
We are talking about Nuno Pinto here.
Yeah, but I think it's a track, there's not that many corners, if you get everything to groove.
Yeah.
I'm sorry to interrupt, but yeah, it's still a mission impossible, isn't it?
Oh, cue the music. Dun, 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 dun.
Well, we had more music for that when Mike Phillies was commentating with us.
Yeah. Back in the good old days.
Yeah. Of Indian history.
Yeah, that was back start 2013.
Yeah. But this year is a new year, so we have you commentated.
Woo!
Yeah. Still the same.
Two of us still the same, we haven't even.
Yeah. Don't change a good thing.
Exactly. Ooh, Pinto's reduced the lead down to 4.2 seconds.
Yeah.
Taking 4 tenths out of him. Maybe he's responding to the music.
Then cue the music.
Dun 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 dun.
Stop. That's enough.
Before we get copyrighted.
I think for Joe and Keeney we should have the Jaws music.
As Moroni goes past the traffic.
Yeah.
And the traffic's
Hector,
making it hard.
Yeah, Hector's not making that easy.
And it just flashes him.
He's impressed.
He's not impressed with me, really.
And out of all this, Pinto's just dropped the gap down to 3 seconds. He's just taken a second out of him. And you can see him now.
Yeah.
So we've got 5 minutes left. This is going to be a very interesting finish. And again, dun, 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 dun.
I think what Pinto learned from race one was to kind of hang back, mind the tires, and go on a charge for the last 5 minutes. And I think that's what we're seeing at the moment. He is just better tires.
Gap down to 2.9 seconds now. And I think also Morelli was getting held up by that traffic, which didn't help. As they come up to Hawthorns now, but do remember Pinto's still got to pass the traffic. And Hector Riviera not making it easy to get past.
Well, although he doesn't have to move this stage, Pinto's not that close. Although he's getting closer and closer, I wouldn't really start moving yet. Although Pinto isn't
Pinto
really impressed.
Pinto has started flashing, yeah. Telling him to get the hell out of the way.
Now I'd get out of the way.
Gap down to 2.8. Riviera still staying online.
Pinto's making mistakes, though.
He's trying to get the slipstream off Riviera. He's going to have to get that out of the way into clearways.
And
finally gives way. Making Pinto go the long way around, though.
Yeah, Spanish don't like Portuguese guys, so...
Inter-country rivalry. Ooh, Pinto just getting a little bit of the back end slide there.
Let's not talk about that.
Ooh, he's very twitchy. Misses the apex.
If I remember correctly, you don't like the Frenchies too much.
Yeah, well, we have to help them in every war. I don't think they're going to get away with that one.
Nope.
Gap hovering now about 3 seconds.
BBC is not going to hire you.
To be fair, they probably would anyway.
Yeah. We could try, though.
Oh, yeah. I'm going along to their next auditions for the Formula 1.
Do they have those things?
I don't know, but let's make one.
Oh.
Let's send a mixtape in of just us commentating. It'd be brilliant.
Actually, at the Autosport show, there was thing where you could end up commentating on the British GT Championship.
Me?
Why didn't I go along to this?
I kind of got nervous and I didn't do it.
Gap down to 2.7 seconds. That would be brilliant, though. And British GT is pretty good.
Yeah. Yes, I love British GT.
I remember when it used to be on Channel 4s in the morning. The highlights. Brilliant.
Back in the day.
Yeah, I lack Sky around here, so I don't get all these fancy motors TV.
Guys,
yeah.
Guys, Reynolds.
Sorry.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah, there's that thing in the background called Ray, isn't there?
Ooh.
Yeah. Gap.
I know GTs are pretty good, but we have to concentrate on the
Reynolds. Says you.
Yeah.
Right, anyway, remember, 100% professional.
Yeah, I don't know what hit me now.
Pinto's just dropped the gap down to 2.6 seconds. He's closing, but he's going to have to increase the rate that he's closing up to Morelli.
Anyway, who won British GT? Was it Aston Martin?
I don't know either. I know of course we're running some 458s
in there,
didn't it?
It was a Aston Martin 007.
Oh, the beach something racing.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh.
You see, I watch Motors TV too.
Am I the odd one out here then?
Yes.
Yes. Even though I'm more into Motors TV for the endurance thing, but...
And the rally.
Yeah, but they are cutting out rallying because of racing.
Fair enough. Gap down to 2.6.
You can see visibly he's closing it, but it's just not going to happen at this
stage.
We've
got 2 minutes to go.
No, that's
2 laps. Then
1
laps.
Minute to go.
One
lap.
It just ticked over to 1 minute. So 1 lap.
Last lap now.
I know there's no way he's going to catch it, is he? And there goes my bet. Damn it. Although nobody won this one, so I still get the beers. Brilliant.
So
send them by email.
You get second. Got 6th or 7th, and then Shane got nothing.
Yeah, my car ended up in a wall.
We said that before the race. It was going to end up in a wall, didn't we?
Yeah. Commentator curse.
Exactly. Gap down to 2.3 seconds, halfway around the lap. Don't think it's going to be enough.
Pinto's winning streak is going to come to an end. Although, hopefully I didn't jinx that now.
I'll take it. It'd be a shame if Morelli was to suddenly gravitate towards a wall. Ooh, he actually almost went out of shape.
He's catching a backmarker.
Yeah.
He's got to get past Ian Stewart. Pinto's pushing like hell now. But I don't think it's going to be enough, and Morelli comes around the second to last corner.
Yep.
Through Clark Curve, and your winner of round 4 of the 2014 Extreme RPM NLC Championship, Mr. Vladimir Morelli for AJ Racing. And then Nuno Pinto brings up second. Another great result for him. Cements his place at the top of the Drivers' Championship.
Yeah, Marcio is going to come third.
That's brilliant for AJ Racing, a first and a third.
Yeah. And then David Reguin's in fourth, which for Lusitanium is good.
Unless that changes on the final straight, I doubt it will. Let's watch Morelli, Machinel even, cross the line. And he does so. David Rego coming up in fourth. And now we've got Antti Hiatalan, solid fifth, followed by Givenhaus straight away in sixth. That was close towards the end.
Yep.
Juan Poyo comes up seventh.
Canarians, guys, coming in.
Yeah, the first of the Canary team, doing well. Then we have
the second one.
Shumikov, and actually top 10, and then we have Nuno Senna comes across in 11th, closely followed by Hilario Souza, 12th.
And Ian Stewart, he's still way back, but he's coming to the finish.
Yeah, exactly.
And the X-Men going, woof, woof, woof.
X-Men's in 15th, so he's picking lapped now by Stewart.
I think Ian Stewart just slowed down because... Yeah.
Fair enough. whilst he crossed the line, I'll just read out the list of retirements. We have Wes McLaren was out, Hugo Silva retired, Francisco Serrao, AJ Yates, Jair Monti, and Govacchini. And Victor Souza got a disqualification for something. Don't know, we'll find that out probably for next week. But that does conclude our stuff for tonight. All our action. It was a very good evening of racing.
Yeah. As always, we won't be going further than this because we don't have all night to do. And
because we're lazy.
Yeah, and tomorrow is day school for both of these two.
Boy.
And so... say your prayers, guys.
Say our prayers. We're going to have death or something.
Mummy.
Bye.
Bye.
Yeah, see you next week, folks.
Yeah, see you next week. Bye for now.
Oh, we've got some better cameras.
Yeah, I have.
Look at that.
Oh, I'm doing
it. Did you know that those idiots from Top Gear are going to launch the new season?
Yes, again. Brilliant. Amazing. Loving a bit of talking. Anyway.